This video brought to you by dbrand.
A demo area that's beautifully lit with natural light. Who'd have thunk it? Hey folks, Juan Bagnell here for Pocket Now. We're just minutes out of the Samsung Unpacked event, and we're going hands-on with the new Galaxy S8 and the S8 Plus. Both of these phones, very similar, just different screen size, quad HD Plus sort of display. It's a little similar to what we were talking about with the LG G6. It's a little bit taller, and that they're really trying to maximize that screen real estate and bringing in those design elements from phones that are missed, like say the Galaxy Note 7, in really creating a beautiful symmetrical device, really nice color options, and a really great feel in the hand. You start hearing about a 5.8-inch diagonal display, and you start getting a little worried, like maybe their smaller phone's really gonna be in phablet territory. And this new aspect ratio, this 2:1 aspect ratio, really does help maximize screen real estate while packing all of that into a much smaller form factor. Now, all of those rumors, all of those leaks, there weren't a tremendous number of surprises for this phone. A lot of this was just getting confirmed. We are looking at an April 21st release for this device, a little bit earlier than we were expecting, so that's definitely great for people wanting to get their hands on the next Samsung. And then all of the other metrics were right on point. We've got the 12 megapixel camera, that dual pixel autofocus that we saw on the S7 and the Note 7, that's made a return. And then a number of new fun features that kind of help maximize the screen real estate, bringing back some of those customizations from previous Samsung devices that could do split screen, especially considering that this is not a standard screen resolution. We do have some tools to make sure that our games will play without pillar boxing, so that's definitely appreciated. And for anyone who was concerned, there is a sort of taptic motory feel to the buttons underneath, so that even though we have on-screen controls, they do resemble hardware controls. I'm still a little torn on the placement of the fingerprint scanner on the back. Every time I reach for this, even on the smaller S8 with my little hobbit hands, I know I'm kind of smudging over my camera to get to the fingerprint sensor. But if that's not your jam, you don't want to have to worry about doing the unlock from the back. We do have face unlock and iris scanning. So we have a combination of two different facial feature unlock modes from the phone, so that should help take some of the pressure off you sort of smearing the back glass of your pretty Galaxy S8 to try and make sure that you can get into your apps and your services. One of the biggest announcements for Samsung on the S8 was, of course, Bixby. It's their software layer where they're going to start incorporating more intelligence into interactions, voice commands, and camera controls. Unfortunately, while there is some Bixby software on this phone, it's not fully activated, so we can't really show you what that's going to look like outside of some of their demo videos. But it does sound like it's got some promise, especially if Samsung can continue to reach out to third-party developers and make sure that their services will integrate with Bixby. Then I think we could see some really cool interactions with getting away from always having to focus both your touch and your eyes and your ears all on one glowing rectangle screen. One of the fascinating things about this symmetrical design is it really does cut back on how big these phones feel. If we put the S8 next to the S8 Plus, the S8 Plus does not feel like a tremendously big device until you compare it to a smaller phone. The way that these sides curve around, I'm a little concerned about holding onto this doing our real camera reviews, but when I went over to start shooting all of my hands-on footage for this video, I was doing almost all of it on the S8 Plus. That's why you see the black S8 Plus in this video, before I realized that I was actually holding the larger of the two phones. I put it up next to my G6, and that's when I realized, oh, I'm holding the phablet version, I should probably switch over. It's already making my hands look small enough as it is. Samsung's building a little story of redemption. The S8 is going to be their flagship phone, not only for, you know, their normal flagship phone delivery at the beginning of the year, then also to continue telling that story of their commitment to their consumers, listening to the products and to the feature sets and to the experiences that people want to have with their mobile devices, and then also looking to the past for some of their missteps to make sure that they don't make those same mistakes again moving into the future.
Did you know that pirates wore eye patches so that when they went below deck, they could remove it and have better vision in the dark? I actually did. We'd like to thank our sponsor dbrand for reminding us that it's tough to see in the dark. This bizarre ad in our Samsung Unpacked event coverage is brought to you by dbrand. Check them out in the link below.
Reliability, consumer safety, and of course improving on all of those experiences that we need to have to get our work done day to day. That's the story that Samsung's trying to tell. And of course, we'll be going hands-on with a few more videos with Jules and with Jaime, looking at different comparisons, looking at the G6, looking at the iPhone, and also, is this a phone that you should consider upgrading from your Galaxy S7? Maybe that one-year upgrade is a little bit more impressive when we start looking at a change in form factor and capabilities. So definitely stay tuned. make sure you're subscribed to this channel for our full Samsung Unpacked coverage. We also got some Gear 360s to play with, so I'll probably be harassing you guys with some 360-degree videos soon. For Pocket Now, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell, some gadget guy on Twitter and Instagram, and I will catch you all on the next video.